going? Nice to meet you, girls. What's your name?
I'm Emily.
Emily, nice to meet you. Hello.
I'm Lily.
Lily, nice to meet you. So when I was about your age, so probably about 12, that was when I first decided I wanted to be Prime Minister. And I always thought that was going to be a really good thing to do. But most people just didn't carry on doing thinking like that. But I did, so yeah, I always wanted to be Prime Minister when I was quite young.
All 33 of our Year 7 and 8 leaders, what advice can you give us on being good role models?
Well, I think the first thing is leaders lead by example, so you shouldn't expect people to do things that you won't do yourself. I think the second thing is you've got to build a really good team about you, so it's really good to communicate to them and talk to them about what you're trying to achieve. I think the third thing is to try and get a bit of a sense of what, you know, what it is that you're trying to achieve, and, you know, work that out amongst yourselves, and hopefully be predictable. So I try and be predictable. If people know what they're going to do, then they don't get surprised by that, and they can understand that, and they can hopefully buy into what you're wanting to do.
What has been your most memorable experience as
Minister? It's memorable. Probably Christchurch with the earthquakes. I think the day I came down in 2011, when you had the really big earthquake, that was a really memorable day because it was a very sad day, and I ended up doing a lot of press down by the CTV building at Latin Square there, so that was very sad. But I've had lots and lots of days, some of them being very happy. I was in the All Black changing room after winning the World Cup, that was a pretty happy day. And I've had lots of different experiences, but probably Christchurch that day would be the most memorable.
What challenges have you come across that have made you a better leader or Prime Minister?
Well, when I first became Prime Minister, we were kind of going broke as a country, so it wasn't quite so good. So we were in recession, and it was it looked like it was getting a lot worse, and then the global, you know, recession came. And so, yeah, in a way, what that means is, you know, mum and dad lose their job, and then, you know, they can't look after their family in the same way they would want to, and all of those things. So a lot of what we've done has been trying to make the country stronger in that regard. So that's a sort of one big level, but then there are lots and lots of different challenges within, you know, health, say, or education, whatever it might be. And some of them are really easy to understand, and some of them are a little bit difficult. Like Christchurch is a really, really big project because we're rebuilding Christchurch. So that's costing a huge amount of money, and it's very complex for people. So it's superficially looks kind of simple to do, but it's actually quite challenging to do.
Thank you for coming and answering our questions and opening our
new
learning environment.
Thank you, that's very nice to meet you all. Good luck for high school next year. And we'll see you soon.
Very good.
Well done.